Welcome to Beat This. We're getting into the brains behind the beats, challenging the best producers in the game to make a beat in 10 minutes. Straight from scratch, no Blue Peter business. We record it all from start to finish. It's been a long time coming. The very first Beat This episode was filmed back in 2007 with a grime producer called Maniac. You might have heard of him, right? This episode, we've got Swindle taking up the Beat This challenge, making a beat in 10 minutes. Make sure you vote in the comments underneath the video on YouTube, yeah? Out of 10, make sure you check Don't Watch That TV, the Beat This channel, for the monthly leaderboard.
Two, one, you're in.
Monkey McMonkey.
Tim's got a curtain on his head. I have to hold it up. That's why we're laughing.
Alright. It's alright, mate, you can pay for it.
It's fine.
It's 500 grand, that's all.
What about this camera then?
Alright, now we're even Stevens, isn't it?
Oh, let me get behind you.
Yeah.
That's a little weird.
And we got it off.
Bad dodginess in the place today. Tell you one thing about old synths, yeah? When a key goes, it's a fucker because you will never remember which one it is until you need it. Seconds left on the clock. What, quick structure?
Yeah, quick structure. Let's go.
Quick structure. Oh, shit. I should try and make all my tunes in 10 minutes, man. It's a vibes, you know that.
How long has he got?
30 seconds. how the song would go, innit?
All right, so it's don'twatchthat.tv. Beat this. We're in Swindle's house. Swindle, what's good, sir?
I'm all good, bub. How you doing? All right.
How was the 10 minute beat sessions?
Pressure.
A lot of it.
Yeah, no, it was fun though.
But you did well, you know.
Yeah.
We're gonna. Everyone's gonna vote on it at the end.
We'll see the tallies,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah. I'm sure you're gonna want to come back and do more and all that. But thanks for letting us in your house to where the magic happens. You know, it's good to see you vibing. And obviously, we're used to hearing the tunes.
Yeah.
So it's good to be here around you when you're doing it and seeing the energy and stuff. Tell the people that are watching how you go about starting a beat.
Just look for some point of inspiration, whether it be like a sound or rhythm, just something that will determine which direction I go in. As soon as I've got that, then I can just build around it.
And obviously you're here, you've got Logic and you've got your keyboards and stuff. What would you recommend, like if there's a kid that's I don't know, they're 14, 15, they want to get into production, what would you say, get that to start with?
I'd probably say Logic, you know.
Just go straight in.
Yeah, because it is possible to learn. It's like, it's not so complex that you couldn't learn it.
And I mean, 2010, obviously the year's almost over. It's been a big year for you. You had the One Extra Thing. You were on there for 6 months, right?
Yeah,
is that done now?
Well, I'm still doing bits and bobs for them. I just did the resident DJ for the Homegrown show for October. But in terms of...
Was that taken over from Target?
Nah, this was alongside Target.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. The Targets, that's his show. That's,
But I mean, apart from that, obviously you had Who Said Funk, which is like your funky EP. You had Air Miles EP, which was on Planet Moon.
Yeah.
And you mean you've done countless remixes. You've done production for Maxstar, Alicia Dixon. You know, there's a lot of UK artists you work with this year. What's coming up 2011?
2011, I'm looking to go in with a lot more vocal tracks. I'm squeezing another instrumental EP out at the back end of this year. You get that one there? That was for Tim.
Yeah, fully. So what's that going to be called?
That is called Playground.
And that's
on Rewinder, which is a Dutch label.
Okay.
Doing another release with Butters label called Mood Swings. And then that'll be kind of the end of the instrumental EPs, and then I can start going over the vocals.
Because when I spoke to you before, I think this is like March, April, you said, you know, trying to make that album.
Yeah,
so that's, I guess, next year, right?
I am making it, but the trouble I've had before is that you make a couple of tunes, you got a good one, you throw it out, it does the circuit or whatever, and then come back round, you've got to go make more new tunes. Like, I've got about 7 tracks that are definitely hitting the album on the hard drive. When I've got another 7, then you can hear one. You know what I mean? And then just make sure that I'm just ahead of myself, so I'm not chasing my tail no more. So when I've got everything ready next year, I'll start flowing out the vocals.
As well as the production, you started DJing this year. Obviously, One Extra, you know, on the wall, they ain't gonna see it. But you've been obviously playing all around the place, like the UK, and also I think you went to Holland and Barcelona and all sorts. So I mean, has that affected your production anyway?
Yeah, because you come home and you're like, do you know what? You realise what tune smashes the club and you're like, I'm going to make another one that's going to smash it even harder. When I made Air Miles, I had no idea what he would do to a club.
And you've seen it firsthand.
And I've seen it firsthand. I was flabbergasted. Come home and made another one, you know?
Yeah.
So that's
why. I need that soon.
Yeah. I'll play it to you. I'll play it before you lot go. I'll play it to you. It's called Mood Swings, and that's what's coming out on the Butters
label. So
that's Butters. January,
All right. I mean, influence-wise, your signature, as it was, we always hear the kind of the jazzy sounds.
Yeah.
I mean, is it from, you listening to a lot of jazz growing up on it, or is
loads.
That's it.
Loads, blues, jazz, like I was just brought up just to be really proud of soul music, you know what I mean? So anything that was made over the last, I don't know, 50 years.
Yeah.
Into it, man. That I keep going back further and further and further, and finding more inspiration from old music than I do in new music.
Yeah, I mean, it's whatever you draw it from, I guess.
That's
but
it.
I mean, it's good to hear that no matter what style, because obviously you do funky, you do grime stuff, you do dubstep, you do stuff that's just kind of experimental, and you can always hear that influence in it, which is something.
Keep it funky, you know, right the way through.
Love that. So we know you use Logic. Obviously, that's the software that you mess with. What kind of plugins are you fucking around with?
Native instruments are probably my favourite for like strings and bits and bobs like that. I try and use as much real sounds as I can.
Yeah.
So if I can use like a real synth, then I will, or piano or guitar or percussion percussion, then I will. But yeah, Native Instruments. I got the whole Native Instruments package. I got all the Waves plugins, Rob Pagin. Yeah, I got as much as I can possibly get, but I try and stay away. You know, like you hear, like the massive patches.
Yeah, the big ones.
Yeah, yeah. Like I'll use them if I know I'm trying to. I'm trying to make a statement by saying let's do something different with the sound, but I try and stay away from the sounds that I know are circulating, you know what I mean, around everyone else who's making music in the same area that I am. Yeah, yeah. Like I ain't got orchestral. Is that what it's called? Orchestral? Yeah. Yeah? I'll never use it. Only because it's probably really good, but I just hear so many people telling me I need it. I just kind of feel like I don't.
Well, I mean, that's the thing with especially dubstep I hear anyway. You hear so much of the same sounds, and it's just like it's good when people such as yourself are kind of reaching out a little bit and using different shit. It's better.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I try to sometimes. You know, the sounds are good, so you use it. I think in the 10-minute dubstep we drew for a little bit of massive, but we had 10 minutes. You know what I mean?
But then in the 10 minutes with the funky, you saw you flipping around and you know using that behind.
So. I would have liked to pull the guitar out and. You know what I mean? I just try and keep it as real as possible. But the sounds that I use, I just want them to sound real. If I could play the trumpet and the curtains, I would go in like that. No, really, I would. If I could have a full band, that's pretty much the plan, really.
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So more live shows in the something that's you want to kind of
incorporate. Yeah, we're working towards it, but it's just not easy or cheap to do. And then you want to tour with it. And
well, obviously, we saw you with... AO and Nadia, I mean,
we're back there this month.
Yeah, I love live.
Yeah, we're back there on the 22nd, so we can test out the live situation and go from there, man.
Yeah. We love that. So, 2011, you know, the album, that's it. Tell people how they can keep up with you.
Hit me on the Twitter, Swindle UK, Facebook, Swindle Space Prod. Got a website, swindleproductions.co.uk. I'm just trying to make myself as accessible on the internet as possible. So, if you Google Swindle Producer, science should come up and you can holler at me pretty easy.
Yeah? So boom, beat this, Swindle in the house. Vote for his videos if you're feeling them, innit?
Please.